Welcome to Ascending DC channel. We are an AWS Certified Partner to provide cloud consulting and technical support to clients who are looking for cloud solutions to tackle the challenge in their day-to-day operations. This video is one of the many short videos we are producing. In each of them, we're going to demo and explain one useful AWS practice that can be used to improve the efficiency and accuracy of your work. All these tricks have been proved effective in our clients' success. If you are a project manager, DevOps, architect, software engineer, or just looking for useful cloud practice, this video is made for you. Please like, share, and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.
Hi, everyone. Today, I'm with Sean, the front-end developer in ASCENDING LLC. You probably built one-page web application with ReactJs or AngularJS. Search engine optimization is always a big challenger for that type of application. Search engine today rely on crawling the content that is on your website. The one-page JavaScript framework ReactJS has many challenges when it comes to SEO. When a crawler tries to click a particular link, it is not able to detect the complete page load cycle. The metadata of the page, which is in place for the search engine, does not get refreshed. As a result, your ReactJS application cannot be seen by search engine and will not be indexed as well be indexed as an empty page, which is not good for SEO purpose. There's a solution for SEO of React-based websites. I will let Sean talk about how to use Next.js to improve SEO and the benefit of using it. Sean, you're up.
Okay, thanks, Rio. I'm Sean, the front-end developer of ASCENDING LLC. As you can see, the Next.js has many benefits. With Next.js, you can let the content to be rendered server-side and to give the crawler something to read. It also has many features like zero configuration, automatic code splitting, file system-based routing, and et cetera. So today I'm going to introduce how to use Next.js to build a project and how to deploy it to for the multiple environments. Okay, let's take a look how to create a Next.js project and how to use Next.js routing. Finally, how to build the Next.js project for different environments. Okay, the first step we need to do is set up the project. For me, I will go to my development folder and use the command line to create the next app. I'm gonna call my app, my app. So the installation process has been finished and we got the My App application. Let's go to the folder My App and we got all the files we need to run the Next.js project. We go to the folder and we can see the Next.js have already helped us to build the whole project structure. As we can see, there are many scripts we already have and the index page. So for the demo reason, we don't need the code they gave us. So I will delete it. And we are gonna run dev to start the server and go to the browser. Okay, let me write a simple code here. As you can see, when I save the file, it will be rendered automatically. It's really fast. So now I'm gonna use a router. The Next.js router allows you to do the client-side route transaction between the pages is similar to a single page application. And in default, the router will automatically route files named index to the root of the directory. And the Next.js has a file system based router built on the concept of page. And when a file is added to the pages directory, it's automatically available as a root. The files inside the pages can be used to define the most common patterns. For example, let us create a products folder. And create a book file. And write some code in it. And now we have two files here, the index and book. So how could I link these two files? Well, a React component called link is provided to do this client-side route transition. First, we're gonna import the component here. It's called link. And we are gonna create a link here and give it the URL, the product and book. And give it a name called book. So as you can see, the browser will refresh again, and we have a link. When we click it, it will go to the book page. It's really fast. Okay, now we have a simple Next.js application, and finally, we will export it for the SEO purposes. So as we can go to the package file here, and we can see there are three scripts Next.js gave us. And we're gonna use build command to build it for the production usage. So we're gonna run npm run build. Okay, we can see the compiled successful, and we got the static web file in .next folder. But the best way to export it will be add a command export. So we're gonna add next export to the build command. So now we're gonna run it again. In this time, we are gonna see a new folder appears, it's out. In this folder, we got all the files we need to deploy your project. Let's take a look on this file. As we can see the out folder, we got several files. Because we will create a link for the book, so the Next.js help us to create separate file for the book HTML and the index HTML. So this is very good for the SEO purposes.
Thank you, Sean, for showing us how to do search engine optimization on one-page JavaScript project, specifically ReactJs, by using Next.js library. If you want to see more videos about web app development, please check out other ASCENDING short videos. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye.
Please leave your comments, questions, critics to us so we know you are watching. Again, please like, share, and subscribe to our channel, ASCENDING DC, and stay tuned for our next video. See you next week.